Hello, we're going to be discussing the usefulness of breeding soundness exam in bulls, particularly for heifers prior to the breeding season. The reason this is important is we want to make sure that our heifers get pregnant early on in the breeding season so that they can calve early on in the calving season and be able to get rebred again the next breeding season. This is especially true if you've synchronized your heifers. You're really going to need a bull that is capable of getting all those heifers bred when they start cycling, the ones that are going to recycle after being AI'd that first time. What a BSE or breeding soundness exam does is it screens a bull to determine whether it's a satisfactory or an unsatisfactory potential breeder. That is only a part of what we call the true fertility of getting a heifer bred, but this is one of the things that we can measure and can control by determining whether or not that bull is a satisfactory potential breeder. So other things that are important for a fertility of a bull and the heifers is the physical capability of that bull to be able to get around and breed those heifers. The sperm quality and quantity, and that's what we a lot of times specifically measure in the breeding soundness exam is the sperm quantity. Other things that go into fertility is the sex drive of that bull, the social rank, so you can have a very fertile bull, but if socially he is not able to breed heifers, he's not going to be able to get the job done. And then lastly, the cyclicity of the females. We can have an extremely fertile bull, but if the females aren't cycling and aren't receptive, he's not going to be able to breed any of those. What BSEs don't is they don't predict fertility. We can use them to identify either a subfertile or an infertile bull, but anything that we can classify as being a satisfactory potential breeder is fertile, but there's a big, large range of what that fertility may or may be. And so what BSEs really do is identify the substandard ones and not classify one bull as being better than another. The other thing that's important to remember about a breeding soundness exam is it's only valid at the time of the test. So things can happen as the sperm mature in the scrotum. Things can happen to that bull that can change that. So just because he had a good BSE last month before he was turned out, if something happened in that 30 days, he could no longer be a fertile bull at that time. Some things that go into a good breeding soundness exam, besides just looking at the sperm, is a general physical exam. The reproductive exam, and then finally to actually look at the sperm and determine whether or not that sperm is of good quality and quantity. Some of the thresholds that we use for determining whether or not a bull is a satisfactory potential breeder is A, the scrotal circumference of the testicles. We recommend for a 15-month-old bull that those be 30 centimeters or more for a circumference. The motility of the sperm, at least 30% of the sperm need to be progressively motile. That means moving forward and able to move and travel through that uterus once they get deposited. And then 70% normal morphology, meaning that they're normal quality. There's no broken tails, there's no abnormal shaped heads, no things like that are going to impair the fertility of those sperm. Again, some of the things that we need to look at besides just the sperm are the physical exam. So we want the bulls to be in physically fit and in a working condition. So we don't want them overly fat. These bulls are going to need to be able to work. So they need to be in good shape. But they're also, if they're working hard, can lose 100 to 300 pounds. So they need to be in good flesh, probably at least a 5, but probably better to be a body condition score of 6 or 7, so that they can get through that breeding season and lose a couple hundred pounds during that time. Their mouth needs to be in good shape. We don't want any broken mouth bulls. We don't want any lump jaws, things like that. These bulls may not eat a lot, but when they do eat, they need to be able to eat as much as they can. And so if we have any mouth problems, they're going to lose weight and aren't going to be able to keep up. Eyes, if they've had a pink eye lesion in the past, that can impair their ability to get around. Bulls are very visual in identifying heifers in heat, and so if they have some bulls that are blind or have a hard time seeing, they're going to have a lower ability in order to identify heifers in heat. feet and legs, these bulls need to get around. They're going to have to follow these heifers around pasture, so we need to make sure they don't have any obvious lameness issues, a stifled bull, a chronic arthritis or foot rot, something like that. But other things that may also lead to that, an interdigital fibroma in between their claws or a screw claw. They may not be severely lame now, but in trying to get around the pasture, those can sure be problems in the future. So make sure that all that the bull's feet and legs are good and sound, and they're going to be able to move once they're turned out. Finally, that leaves us with the reproductive exam. So, again, particularly for older bulls, we want to make sure that everything is normal there. They haven't had a laceration or something like that in the past that's going to impede that reproductive organs. So we want to take a good look at the prepuce, make sure there's no scars or lacerations, hematomas, those types of things. Make sure there isn't a hair ring around that penis that's going to make it painful for the bull to breed a heifer. Any sort of a fibropapilloma or a wart on that penis that can impede that. And then finally, take a look at the scrotum. We need to have some normal shape testes, particularly coming out of winter. We can have some issues with frostbite and those types of things that can cause some problems. So we want to make sure that those testes are normal and should be able to produce good quality sperm. So in summary, when we're getting ready to send heifers out to pasture, to the breeding pasture, doing a breeding soundness exam on your bull is one step to that, to make sure that we've got a fertile bull that we're putting out there to get these heifers bred. Particularly if we've got a group of synchronized heifers that are going to all be coming back into heat on about the same day, we really need a bull that's capable of getting all those cows or heifers bred in that short amount of time. And that's, again, if we're going to keep this heifer in the herd for a long time, we need to get those heifers bred early on in the breeding season. So having a very fertile bull is going to be key in order to get that done. So thank you, and wish you success in your breeding season with your heifers.